pieces.
I'm like, why y'all got people in your ear? But I guess completely for that. That we are not on the same line.
Yeah. There it is.
Do you think we should?
Did you really just say sup, cuz? Really,
BRB. I'm gonna add you. Or you add me.
How about I add you?
In person.
Who? Him? I said. No. Oh.
Can you hear the music? No.
You're live. I can't tag you because you're live. Child doing. Okay, hold on. If you know Queen Sylvia Speaks' page, well, nah, it's gonna pop up. Okay. This is gonna end.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is, because it just said my live stream has to end in order for yours to begin. Oh. And it's gonna reappear. So this is gonna reappear. So just log back in. All right, praise God.
Or just you and me. Sorry, y'all. We had this issue every week.
Literally, I just.
You
no,
add me.
But mine wasn't acting right. You add me. You found me. I couldn't find you. Oh, we finna have Testimony Tuesday up in here. That's what we're doing, Elmer. Yep. Yep. Yep.
Find me, bro.
What is this every week? Okay.
We're coming. So sorry. How are you doing? That was a little crusty. It's weird and suspicious. So you had to just accept it the first time.
Wow.
Accepted it the first time. Wow.
Definitely forgot that hi Virginia. We are definitely live on Facebook too.
Oh wow, hi.
Freaking about Facebook. Poor Facebook. Oh my goodness. Okay. Hello, lovely people. We about to get this party cracking. What's up, Quentin? What's up, Kyra? I mean, I already said hi to Kyra. All right. So shall we pray?
We should.
Okay. Just please don't look at me. All right. Oh, Heavenly Father, we come to you in prayer. We're saying thank you, Lord, for this time of sharing, oh God, because sharing is caring, oh Heavenly Father. A time of intimacy to stretch out to your people, oh God, to encourage intimacy, Lord. And to build, oh God, to encourage vulnerability, oh God. We want to build, oh God. So we're saying thank you for this opportunity to go before your people. And Lord, let your words be our words. And your nerves be our nerves tonight. So, in Jesus' name we pray, amen. I can still hear it over here.
I know. This might not be a good idea.
Mm-mm. I don't think it is.
No. Is the interference too much? No, that is bad.
Wait, Kyra, can you hear the echo?
Do y'all think we should do this, or we should just be on separate lines? Now we look up to both of them, like it's not the same thing.
decisions. Why do we do this every week? This is horrible. It wasn't doing this a minute ago. I think we should just do two separate lives. And these angles on my face are just nuts.
Okay.
All right, I'm going live on my page.
Well, I'm gonna just click out there.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I was like.
Hey, people, Facebook.
Yes. See, okay, yeah, Virginia said that she could hear it. Echo. Okay, cool. So now we have fixed this issue. And hopefully we can get some of these people back.
I know, I'm so sorry.
Yep. All right, but we also don't have that much time. So let's get this. Yay, people actually came back. Praise God. Okay. So this week's Testimony Tuesday, we are talking about
Jesus.
Yeah, I mean, pretty much that is what we're talking about. We're talking about abandonment. I know, heavy topics. I feel like I'm finna go first, aren't I? Yep, your face said it all. All right, best, say less. So,
attention, library patrons. The library will close in 20 minutes. The public computers will shut down in 10 minutes.
Yeah, we cannot win. We cannot win. Oh, my Jesus.
Bro.
Oh, Lord. We cannot win.
I swear we can't win for losing. It don't matter where we go.
We got the victory.
We have the victory of... I just don't know.
So sorry. Okay. So sorry.
It's fine. Let's get back to this topic, guys. So, abandonment. You ain't gotta go home.
I'm scared.
But you
made that real clear.
Look. I'm like, dang. Okay, so this is the story that I'm gonna share today. All right. So abandonment. The way that I define this term. Actually, you know what? No. So technically speaking, abandonment typically talks about someone leaving you or you feeling deserted in some capacity, right? Mm-hmm. And I did a series of interviews last year. Wow, my Lord, last year, that's crazy. And while I was doing these interviews, that was one of the topics that I was talking about, right? And one of my interviewees like completely blew my mind out of the water. For him, he said that abandonment, he felt deserted when there was a lack of reciprocity in his relationships, whether it was familial, platonic, or romantic, any of it. Like, he felt deserted when there was a lack of reciprocity, and that definitely hit me because I had never contemplated it like that. Like that's literally why I did the interviews, was to gain perspective, right? And that brings me to my story. Okay. So, in the words of a great friend of mine, when I was a children, that's what she says, I had a very tragic event occur to me, right? Very tragic. And it resulted in my mother passing, right? She had, her doctor gave her the wrong prescription and it cost her life. Now, as a child, it's hard for adults to process death, but children have to find some sort of logic to attach to. And it was in that interview that I was able to gain some of the wording for how I felt about that, right? And I just remember being this kid who was like this protector. Like, I was everybody in my head, right? I was everybody's protector. I went above and beyond. Like, and when my mom passed away, in my head, I was like, you ain't putting in the work that I'm putting in, man. Like, you just decided to walk away from me. Mm-hmm. I don't know why I'm looking at you right now, but it just feels just working.
It's okay. Yep. Sometimes we need people to act it out.
Yeah, I'm projecting right now. Yeah. Okay. Just, wow.
It's just, you know, I apply the blood of Jesus. Wow. Shield of faith is up. It's fine. It won't come near me. It won't penetrate. But act it out.
Come on. Yeah. I like that. That was good. Mm-hmm. That was good. Mm-hmm. Digging deep. Mm-hmm. Okay. I hope that wasn't you digging. Kind of pathetic that was. Anyways, but for me, it was learning those. It was for me, I was like, wow, like I, in my brain, it was like crazy because, like I said, I felt like all of a sudden she was no longer doing the work. I mean, clearly she couldn't. She wasn't doing the work that I was. She was falling short on her duties, or she was tired of doing her duties, and therefore she chose to leave me. Mind you, like I said, I'm 7. I have to use some type of logic to wrap my head around this tragedy. And the offset that had in my life was like tremendous. And I mean like tremendous. Because from then on out, I overcompensated for a very, very long time in a lot of my relationships. I was a very, very lovey child, a very, very touchy child. One of my greatest love languages is physical touch. And I was just, I started to overcompensate because I needed to replace what it was that I had lost. In my mind, if I was not good enough to keep her, I would have to prove myself to everybody that now came into my circle, that now came into my path. I had to make sure that everybody had a reason to stay and to love me. I was worthy to be loved. And somebody was gonna love me one way or another. That's all that I knew. That followed me into adulthood, and like the offset of it was like, so I have a book coming out, y'all. So, and in the book, I talk about how firepower. In the book, I call these things ailments, right? And how one ailment does not come by itself. It comes with friends.
Buddies.
It comes with all types of buddies. Abandonment for me came with perfectionism and lust. Because as I got older, all of a sudden, because I had this void, because it left this massive gaping door open for other things to come through and other issues for me to feel abandoned to walk in as well, I started looking for other ways to satiate my urges. I literally can remember being in 8th grade, right? And writing a poem called Appetites. And the poem literally talks about how my appetite was never fulfilled. Like how if you knew me, sis was the president of this, that, and the other. I was the leader in this, that, and the other. I was doing talent shows. I was in plays. I did everything. My name was like literally known just across the board. And it was because I was trying to fill this void consistently. And then the poem outlined how I had this issue with food. Oh my God. And now I'm in my 20s working through this. Never really contemplated that. That's crazy that I was talking about this in 8th grade and now I'm 27 talking about this. That's weird. That's suspicious. But the second part of the poem was talking about how, so it went from my accolades to being filled by food. And then the last part was how I was looking to be fulfilled by men or boys at the time, like the attention, right? And that void that that abandonment, that initial, and like that wasn't like the initial one. That was just one that had like a really profound impact. Like it really hit home, and it got me because I was like, whoa. Okay. How did I get here? And it's I think as wild as I'm sitting here literally talking about it, like I knew what was going on. I just didn't know how to fix it. And I think I tried so hard to bury it over the years, until I got into a place where I was like, why am I doing some of the things that I do? I don't know. And I'm dead serious. Like I said, I'm 27. I didn't ask anybody like the real story of how my mother died until I was roughly 25 or 24. Mind you, my mom died when she was 24. So it took me to breach the threshold. It took me to breach the threshold of her age for me to actually be like, I should probably fix a few things. So I'm going to fix a few things. And I started making moves. That really never clicked that I wrote that poem. And like, that's still the same stuff that I ended up dealing with. And it just got worse. That's crazy. But it was a lack of reciprocity for me. Like I was looking for something to feel. I was looking for something to feel me. Because I felt like I, in my head, like I said, and I had pushed it down so deep that I didn't know that it existed, but I felt like she did it on purpose. And even though I know she didn't, clearly she didn't choose that, but the only thing that made plausible sense to me as a child was that she left me on purpose. That was her portion. She didn't want to deal with me anymore. And that's why she chunked deuces. And I was like, and now being older, I'm like, okay, so now we should go back and like reevaluate this. Like, no, she loved you and she got called home to glory. So there's that.
So how do you find now that you are walking with Christ and you are, you know, walking out this healing, right? How do you find now this affects your relationship with Christ? Dealing with abandonment and him working with you to heal it. Like, how does that show up in your relationship with him?
At first, so if anybody like knows me, like, when most people at my current church first met me, I was like hyper independent. I was like, Miss, I don't need nobody. I can do it by myself. And to an extent, I'm still kind of that way. I am definitely a work in progress. But I said that to say this, because now I'm in this season where God is like, you no longer are in the season to make things work. That's my job. And it has taken everything out of me because I had to overcompensate for myself. I had to build myself, and that's how I felt. So that also impacted how I viewed God, like unconsciously. Because I'm like, yeah, because before all this, I was like, yeah, I know God exists. That's great. Whatever. But I didn't trust him. Why? Because we have parental figures for a reason, right? They're our first essential guides, and I'm not trying to make it sound like that, but literally we idolize our parents as children and even as adults, even if they're trash. We try to find the best in them. And because of that, we end up, we project our relationship, our parental relationship onto God because he's our parent. Right? He's our comforter. He's our friend. But first and foremost, he's our parent. And for me, I was like, well, like I said, subconsciously, if that was my portion, if she left, then by right, you are also going to leave. And that's literally how I felt about it. I was like, I don't understand the purpose or the point of me trying to invest my energy, invest my trust into this if you can do the same thing that she did. And then, like I said, I was hyper independent, so like I had to do it on my own, and like that lack of trust is now coming back, because like that is literally my faith walk right now, is learning to trust God with everything. And it's the weirdest thing in the world for me, because I'm like, I can do that by myself. And he'd be like, nah.
And can't.
And cannot.
So I'm going to say this, because I know we got to wrap up soon. Mm-hmm. Y'all pray mm-hmm. that the Lord blesses me, more particularly, both of us, with an office space, okay? So we can record couch conversations, all of that. But so we can have more time.
Yeah,
that's good. My last question is, and maybe we'll have to do a part two to this, so we can continue to go deeper, but is, what have you found in your life where there was patterns of you abandoning things, people, places, projects, situations?
Hurt people. Mm. That's good. That's a good question. Yeah. Ooh, hurt people. I am a visionary.
The library will be closing in 5 minutes. Please make your final selections.
Y'all, pray that God blesses us with a space. They said, y'all got to go ahead. Come on up out of here.
I don't know where you finna go, but you finna get up out of here. You don't gotta go home, but you got to leave
here. So I almost feel like we should pink slip.
Not pink slip.
But I almost feel like we should leave it as a cliffhanger.
That is good. And I might actually tease people with like a little video of that this week. Can you reiterate the question one more time just so we can leave people? Wow. Okay.
What part in your life, because you have experienced abandonment yourself, where areas, what parts of your life where you have abandoned things, people, places, situations, projects, etc.? Y'all ponder on it, okay?
Facts.
And the teacher in me is going to give y'all the homework assignment. And think about what area you were abandoned in. Did you feel or experience some form of abandonment? And what area have you abandoned something? Let us know. Thanks so much for tuning in. Yeah, we just got the, you know.
Pretty much.
Just got the, she's the writer, so we're just gonna leave a good little cliffhanger like that, and just, you know, we got to keep you got to taste and see, you know, you got to keep coming back to the living well, you know what I'm saying? Come on, Rena.
Come on. So with that being said, I'm liking this commentary, Serena. I'm just putting it out there. A forced clip. Aren't all cliffhangers forced though? So, we will see you guys next week. Please tune in next week. And we gonna keep this conversation going. Thank you for tuning in. We really appreciate you guys. And make sure you do your homework, because I'm definitely going to do a midweek check-in to see if you actually did it or not, or if you've been thinking about it. All right. Praise out. Praise God.
Jesus, fill the spaces so we can fill the spaces. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Blood of Jesus, cover y'all all. Amen. We'll be back. Come back, okay? You hear? Amen. All
right, let's go. Let's actually log off.
Actually log off on that, too.
Yep. Hold on, wait. Yep, I'm going to end this one.